Our son Tyler, our middle son, was diagnosed with a brain tumor in April of 2018.
The mass starts in his right thalamus and then expands with roots down into a lot of parts of his brain, which makes this tumor inoperable.
In October, I had a bump on top of my head. On January the 5th, he took a biopsy of it, said it was fast aggressive melanoma cancer.
I have stage 4 metastatic cervical cancer. Within a year, it came back a third time and it metastasized into my lymphatic system as well as some lung nodules that they were concerned about.
I met with the oncologist. The biopsy confirmed that was not Hodgkin's lymphoma.
VHL actually can cause both benign and cancerous tumors in various parts of the body. You name it, I've probably had it.
When I started my life in science, chemotherapy and radiation therapy were really the only armament for cancer medicine. We have now a revolution in immune therapies. And when you put that together with the combination of targeted therapies, chemo and radiation therapy, we now have patients that would have died within 2 years of a diagnosis, living 15, 20, 25, 30 years, essentially cured of their malignancies.
I don't know how my story will end, but in no chapter will it say that I ever gave up.
I had benign and cancerous tumors in my pancreas and kidneys. I actually also had a tumor on my cerebellum. About 8 months after having that Whipple procedure, I had to go back in for brain surgery.
The brain cancer was slow growing, and so we waited and we watched it over a year. Then it started to grow faster, and we knew that we didn't want his last days or months to be spent in the hospital on chemo treatment. If this tumor was going to take his life, we wanted him to live it up, live every minute, every moment.
The new therapeutic approaches that we're successfully seeing in the clinic, those advances stem from basic science discoveries 20 or 30 years ago. Sustained funding has brought those ideas and approaches along to the clinic, where they're now FDA approved standard of care medicines.
Science is amazing. They came out with inhibitors to target his exact mutation. We've been on the treatment now for over 2.5 years with a stable tumor.
There was a clinical trial of belzutifan. I was one of the lucky ones. It's 3 pills that I take. It's a once a day thing, pretty simple. Mentally, physically, I am greater now probably than I ever have been. This drug to me has just allowed me to sit back, relax, and really enjoy every moment.
I got the CAR T cell therapy May 31st. I think that I'm feeling better.
From March the 4th of 2020, I still have no cancer. I've done scans every 12 weeks.
Being in a clinical trial was very eye-opening. I was given 15 months in November of 2018, and we are now in 2022.
There's still a lot of biology we don't understand that requires new investments while we maintain investments in the translational pipeline from the discoveries of 10, 15, 20 years ago.
Cancer researchers, keep doing what you're doing. Keep looking for new medicines to cure cancer. Keep up the good work.
I would say to members of Congress, I believe wholeheartedly, maybe not in my lifetime, but I hope in my niece and nephews, cancer isn't thinking, when am I gonna die?
There's a lot of others out there like me that need a real chance at life, and a drug like this is just life-changing. So if we could fund as much research as possible, all that's going to give us more time with our loved ones.
And it's not going to happen unless help just given to these brilliant people out here that are sitting in labs, researching day in and day out to find ways to cure someone like me.
I feel that more funding needs to go towards childhood cancer and other cancer to find cures. We need more funding, more trials, more studies, so that we can start curing these cancers.
Congressmen, Congresswomen, you need to fund this. You need to keep it up. You need to keep going with this. It's saving lives through these trials.